Don't let procrastination or perfection paralysis hold you back any longer in your walk with Jesus. By the end of this episode, not only will you know my best method to overcome procrastination, but you will also be a productivity powerhouse that gets more done in less time. You've got a dream to glorify God and make your mark on the world. Maybe you want to grow a business, start a ministry, or become a better servant leader. Whichever level in life you want to hit, I believe that God's calling all of us towards something greater than where we are now. So join me as I document my journey to learn how to grow an online ministry in ways that are effective, biblical, and aren't stuffed with complicated religious or business mumbo jumbo. My name is Alec Kassan, and welcome to the Digital Ministry Mastermind Podcast. Good morning, current Christian family. What's going on, you guys? It might not be in the morning for you as you're listening to this, but I just woke up super early, wanted to get this podcast recorded because in the last episode, I left you on a bit of a cliffhanger. In last week's episode, we talked about perfection paralysis and the devastating effects that it can have in preventing you from achieving the great things that God has planned for your life. And I had hinted at a tactic that I use all the time to overcome this perfection paralysis. And this trick that I'll be teaching you in this episode is super simple and very effective. It's allowed me, honestly, to write the Planting Your Purpose book. And now that I'm thinking about it, it's allowed me to start this podcast that you're listening to right now. And the trick that I'm going to be sharing with you is simple. It's three little words. Do it crappy. Don't get confused by the meaning. I'm not telling myself to do a crappy job. Rather, I'm just like giving myself permission to start the task, even if it initially does come out crappy. And this is a trick that I actually learned from the writer, producer, Dan Harmon. He's made Rick and Morty, the show Community. He's a fantastic writer, really creative guy. And in an interview, he talks about how his approach to writing is to start with just writing out a bunch of crap on paper. This allows his creative juices to start flowing. Plus, when he gives himself the goal of creating something crappy to start, the expectations, they're just set so low that it's practically impossible to fail or put it off till later. And Dan Harmon, in many respects, is like a genius when it comes to writing, and people expect a lot from him because of the things he's done in the past, but he doesn't allow the burden of expectation to weigh him down. This way of thinking, it actually reminds me a lot of how David approached his battle with Goliath. This is a tale that has been repeated and shared time and time again, so I won't bother to go into the details, but what I would like to highlight is a very specific moment. Before David goes to fight Goliath, King Saul gives David his own armor. And keep in mind, David is like literally a boy. He's like maybe 10, 15 years old, whereas Saul, who is not only a grown man, he's known for being like the tallest guy in Israel. Like not just like his little town, but like Israel. Known for being the tallest guy in Israel, he thinks, "Oh, I'm going to give my armor to this little kid. It'll help him out." And as you can imagine, Saul's armor would be extremely cumbersome for a child to wear, which it was. And David knew this. So David kindly took the armor off that Saul had placed on him and decided to go into battle as is. And in our lives, we have people place their expectations on us in a similar way that Saul placed his armor on David. But we need to understand that in many instances, we're good as is. So when I say do it crappy, I'm really telling myself to just go for it as I am. Because even if it does come out crappy, it's still significantly better than producing nothing. And it's something that God can make amazing. And as a wrap up, I would like to actually end on this note. And that is, the world's most expensive coffee is crap. Now, I'm not saying it tastes like crap. I'm saying it's made from literal crap. There's this coffee called Kopi Luwak. It's the world's most expensive coffee, and it's made from coffee beans that are plucked from civet's feces. Now, civet is not a person. It's actually like a type of cat. It's like a really large cat, and I guess they eat these coffee beans, and then these people go dig through their poop and then pull those coffee beans out. And why is the world's most expensive cup of coffee made from crap? Pretty much because the world says so. So if you are worried that you need things to be perfect before you can start, You should know that even if your best effort comes out like crap, it might just be the most valuable thing in the world. So, hey, if you enjoyed this episode, I want to invite you to join us, subscribe as I'm documenting my journey of learning things even more. And if there's someone in your church or if there's someone who you know who's in ministry that you think would benefit from listening to content such as this, please go ahead and share this with them. Thank you so much for listening, and I'm super excited to see you in our next episode. Are you a Christian leader looking to develop the skills needed to maximize the fruitfulness in your daily walk with Christ? Do you want to overcome the burden of not living life to the fullest and fully step into your God-given calling? If you do, then you should get a copy of my book, Planting Your Purpose, a 20-day guide to discover God's calling. It's not just another devotional book. Planting Your Purpose is your 20-day guide that will provide you with the strategies, tools, and insights to turn things around immediately. You will learn how to avoid the top 5 mistakes Christians make when pursuing their calling in life. You'll develop more joy in your walk with Jesus and unlock the secrets to mastering integrity. And by the end of 20 days, not only will you know your calling, but you'll have an even greater sense of fulfillment and confidence in your life. Everywhere, Christians are raving about this amazing new guide to discover their God-given calling. Get your copy by clicking the link in the show notes or by going to plantingyourpurpose.com. That's plantingyourpurpose.com.